This week has been packed with news of all kinds, but for once in a long time, most of them are pretty positive. From AOA's Jimin making her long-awaited comeback to even more idols getting cleared of malicious rumors, I have a lot of positive things to share with you. After their historic revival last year, Brave Girls are prepared to show us that they're ready to dominate 2022 as well. According to the Korea Herald, Brave Girls are set to have a comeback sometime between February and March of this year. The comeback date and title are still to be announced, but if we know anything about these girls, it's that they'll never disappoint with their releases. Call me delusional if you want, but I'm predicting that this is gonna be their year. I can feel it in my bones. Okay, who at Big Hit suggested that the BTS and TXT members should open their personal Instagram accounts? If anyone here deserves a raise, it's them. On January 6th, Yeonjun shocked everyone when he opened his own Instagram account and posted a picture of himself with a caption, "Hi." His first follower was Taehyun himself, who showed his support on Weverse, and since he doesn't have his own account, everyone just assumed he did it from the official TXT account. But Moa, sharp-eyed as ever, noticed a small red dot below the profile icon that means that he has other accounts linked to his Instagram. It's not yet known when the other members will be launching their own accounts too, but it looks like it's going to happen soon. Fingers crossed, Ulim has some, strange marketing tactics, and it didn't work out very well for them. On January 6th, the profile photos and covers of the Twitter and Facebook accounts of Ulim entertainment artists such as Infinite, Isudong, Golden Child, Rocket Punch, Drippin, Kwan, and even Lovelies changed to mysterious images, and it got attention immediately. Naturally, speculations that their social media accounts were hacked started because it was the only theory that made sense. However, this all turned out to be a part of Drippin's comeback promotion. After the accounts were hacked, the comeback's prologue film for Drippin member Dogyeon was released, revealing him to be the hacker. But after the accounts went back to normal, Ulim dealt with unexpected backlash. Lovelies fandom found the situation disrespectful towards other groups. The main issue was with Lovelies, and let me tell you why. Fans got angry because after Lovelies disbanded, Ulim still used their accounts for promotions of other groups. Sure, Drippin shouldn't be blamed as they don't have control over their promotions, but Ulim should have known that this would backfire. After 2 years of complete silence from a former AOA member, Jimin finally made an appearance on social media, and it was right on her birthday. She celebrated it by releasing a new song, which might mean that she's ready to enter the K-pop world once again after her name was cleared at the end of 2021. Before she dropped the song, fans noticed that she had changed her highlights on her Instagram, but didn't expect anything else. But then she also released a song on SoundCloud under the name Dodo, titled Suddenly. The song itself is devastating, guys, and it seems like it describes what she dealt with during the time she was dealing with everything. And with lyrics like, "I lost my everything except myself," you can't expect me to not shed a tear or two. Her supportive bestie Sohyun was one of the first to like her post, but she isn't the only one excited to finally have Jimin back. Netizens have also expressed excitement over her comeback, feeling glad that the scandal didn't bring her completely down. I must say, I think we as a K-pop community have let Jimin down because almost no one tried to look at the things from her perspective as well, and everybody sided with Mina, including me. I'm glad we got to see the truth though, and if we learned anything from this whole controversy, it's that we should always hear two sides of the story before jumping into conclusions. On that note, welcome back, Jimin. 2022 truly seems to be a different year for both K-pop fans and idols. It's safe to say that things are finally looking up as idols are getting cleared of the terrible rumors that seem to have been the trend in 2021. You know how school mistreatment is taken extremely seriously in South Korea? I mean, at least on the surface. We all know how it's depicted in the K-dramas and that the situation is bad. Anyway, last year, trolls thought that it would be funny to target as many idols as they can and try to ruin their careers over false accusations. April as a whole have been facing a few issues since 2021. One of the members, Hyunju, accused her fellow members of mistreating her, and their career went down the drain in a blink of an eye. The group and the members lost several gigs, got tons of hate, and lost many fans in the process. But since people started finding some suspicious loopholes in Hyunju's story, the general public is once again warming up to April. And now we have a confirmed update on Naeun's case of her alleged bad behavior as well. On January 7th, DSP Media released a statement which revealed that the accuser had admitted that her claims were all made up, and that they even had submitted an apology letter to Naeun. Sure, because the apology letter will totally erase all the hell she had to go through the last year because of these accusations. The label also shared that a lawsuit against the accuser has been filed, and the police have finally found the accuser guilty of defamation. DSP Media said that the accuser actually reached out to Naeun, apologized, and shared that they would be deeply reflecting on their actions. That doesn't undo the damage that her career has suffered, but it's a start. DSP Media representative claims that Naeun has decided to accept A's apology and will be dropping the defamation charges against the accuser. future. However, they shared that they would take legal action against any future activities involving fake and malicious rumors against their artists. The accuser also shared that they made their rumors up because they were lonely and jealous of Naeun. Let me just tell you the exact words. "I was jealous of the Naeun who was always bright and actively getting along with many friends compared to my quiet self that lacked a presence in elementary school. I once again sincerely apologize to Naeun and DSP Media who were greatly harmed by the false post I wrote, along with Naeun's fans who must have been very troubled. I will live while self-reflecting forever." It isn't fair that these people are let off the hook when they almost ruin Naeun's life and career. Can we all just make it a thing that in 2022 we won't be jumping on hate wagons? For real, guys. My girl IU has found herself in yet another strange controversy, and it really seems like people are grasping at straws so they can find reasons to hate on her. As if she wasn't the biggest angel in K-pop. IU ended the year on an emotional note by gifting her fans an album titled Pieces, which is full of songs that haven't been released officially during her career. She explained the meaning behind the album as each of the precious pieces helped her form a complete picture. On January 4th, Adam also announced that IU will be releasing a documentary film called Pieces, A 29-Year-Old's Winter, to share the behind the scenes of the album making process. Things took a wrong turn though when some Korean UENAs who were relatively more well known in the fandom shared that a team member for the documentary had personally contacted them for interviews. In addition, there were also complaints that these fans were also receiving goods and CDs signed by IU from the company staff, so fans naturally began demanding that the process behind the selection procedure be fair. Why are they acting like IU was personally involved in the process though? Do they think that she doesn't have other things to do? Girl is busy being a freaking legend. Like, please. I'm amazed how some K-pop fans cannot be happy for others. Before things escalated even further, the agency released a statement with the intention to clear up any misunderstandings. They started by revealing that they are currently in the last stages of making the documentary, and ever since the pre-sale for the documentary was announced, they have been consistently monitoring discussions on social media to see the fans' reactions. That's how the issue was brought to their attention in the first place. Then they shared that this was the personal behavior of the writers of the production team and was not instructed by IU or the company. The agency stated, "We came across points that could be misleading and would like to clarify the true facts." The documentary writer contacted fans and conducted interviews at his own discretion to investigate the data necessary for the pre-meeting to select the production company. Then they revealed what happened to the writer in question and the content he was working on. They also apologized to the fans about the misunderstanding. The writer left the project before making the documentary and the collected content was not included. The documentary production team, including ours, were not in a situation where we would have received any information related to this in advance. We sincerely apologize to fans who may have been worried about this misunderstanding. In response to this, a netizen commented, "I don't think IU's even the kind of person to discriminate against fans like that. I don't think real fans would think much of this." Exactly. Why is my girl involved in controversies when she does literally nothing bad? She keeps on making donations, and she's actually the one who is vocal about changing the K-pop entertainment industry. Looks like some people need to check themselves first. Anyway, let me know your thoughts in the comments. Hope you have a great day and see you next time. Bye.